What? Good neighbor ain't good enough for you? Go check out Covenant. Heard that place is all kinds of fancy.
Looks like we got another freak, just won't fit anywhere else.
Might stop by the memory den later. There was this girl a few months ago. Man, oh man. Wouldn't mind seeing those curves again.
Good neighbor, you handle your own problems, or you end up dead.
Too bad about Finn. Gonna miss him next Super Mutant Attack rolls round. Oh well. What can I do for our newcomer?
What's your story, Hancock?
My favorite subject. I came into this town about a decade ago. Had a smooth set of skin back then. While I was busy making myself a pillar of this community, I would go on these, like, wild tears. I was young. Any chems I could find, the more exotic, the better. Finally found this experimental radiation drug. Only one of its kind left, and only one hit. Oh man, the high was so worth it. Yeah, I'm living with the side effects, but hey, what's not to love about immortality?
You're immortal?
Well, not exactly. Ghouls just age really, really slow. Something about the rads, maybe? Who knows?
You're a hell of a risk-taker, Hancock.
Only have one life. Why not try it all? Anyway, did you need something else?
Tell me more about this town of yours, good neighbor.
It's all about the people, understand? They're freaks, misfits, and troublemakers. And that's why I love them. Everyone here lives their own life, their own way. No judgments. Now, was there anything else?
Did I hear you talking about the Institute?
You like my little speech? I do it every once in a while in case they're listening in. I want those synth makers to know that Good Neighbor is off limits. No one gets replaced in my town. But hey, weren't we talking about your needs? What did you come here for?
Why does the Institute replace people?
Hell if I know. Mess with people's heads? Control us from the shadows? Or maybe they do it just because they can. No one knows where the Institute is, what kind of people they are, or why they've decided to engineer their own slaves. But there it is. Just to be clear, everyone's welcome in Good Neighbor. I don't care if you're a synth, ghoul, or even a super mutant, so long as you play nice. And let me tell you, synths still under the Institute's control don't play nice. Done talking about this. What else you need?
Looking for work.
Work, huh? I'll tell you what, I got reconnaissance needs. There's a lot of weird talk coming in about a place called the Pikmin Gallery. It's Raider territory up there, but they've been quiet. Like uncomfortable post-coitus quiet. Snoop it out and give me the word.
What else can you tell me about Pikmin Gallery?
Nothing. That's why I'm paying you to go out there.
I might be interested, but let's talk money, Hancock.
Okay. Usual job pays 200, but I like you. So let's push it to 250.
You said things have gone quiet up there. That means extra risks to cover.
I like where your head's at. Let's make it 300 caps.
Scout out Pikmin Gallery. On it.
Cool. Be thorough, okay? I'm not paying for a look-see.
Find out what's really going on there.
A new player in Good Neighbor. Hello, little pawn. Welcome to our fun and games.
Excuse me.
You ever tried chess? Sometimes you need to sacrifice a piece to keep the game going. Keep that in mind.
Buddy, I need to be a lot more high or a lot more drunk to be bothered right now.
Nice, Pip-Boy. Who'd you kill to get that, huh?
Hey there. You're new around Good Neighbor, if I'm not mistaken. What do you think of the place?
Why do you ask?
Just trying to get a feel for you. Ain't exactly the safest neighborhood, so I like to know who's gonna cause.
Name's Rufus. I do repairs around here.
Mm-hmm. I'm usually fixing stuff over at the Hotel Rexford. Or drinking. Looking for parts?
What's the job?
Don't know if you've had the beer down at the third rail, but I swear,
Found this holotape while doing repairs at the Rexford. Thing is, it was never delivered. Well, with all the bombs and all.
Right.
Which is where you come in.
I assume this is a paying job.
Of course. How about 200 caps and some of the beer? Think you can get a hold of that brewing machine for me?
This isn't exactly the safest.
Fair point. 300 caps. Plus beer. Are you gonna take the job?
I'm in. Let's do it.
Great. So, the brewing machine is in the basement of an old bar called the Shamrock Tap House. When you leave town, make your way around east till you hit Atlantic. Great big grain sign. Bring it back here when you're done.
Hey, Rufus.
How's it going?
You find that brewing machine yet? Or are you just here looking for scrap?
So about the job.
Some sort of brewing machine at the...
I'll take a look.
Let me show you what I got.
Fred? Are you going to hang out in the lobby all day again, or are you actually going to go down and do some work?
Being available to the customers is work. It's not all about cooking chems, Claire.
It's not all about sampling those chems either. Maybe if you stopped using, you could focus.
What? Where's the fun in cooking it if you ain't using?
I just clean up around.
My mistake.
Oh man, someone new! You need some Jet, man? Home-brewed? Reasonable prices?
What's Jet?
You don't know? It's the best. It just hypercharges.
What other kinds of chems do you have?
Well, you got your medicinal shit. Rad-X and Rad-Away for radiation sickness. Hey, do you think that's why they call it Rad-X? That's far out. Mentats are for the sciencey types, you know, eggheads looking for a boost to solve big problems. Buff outs for the muscle men. Fuck, just try it all is what I say.
You have any work?
Yeah, actually, you might be perfect. You know the gunners, right? The high-end mercenaries? Well, a few of them were talking about scavenging around that old hallucinogen building. I mean, just think about that name. There's gotta be some shit there that's out of this world. You get me something, I pay you 200 caps. Hey, just say anything.
You said there are gunners out there?
The blackest hearted mercs around. So, you know.
Your offer's a little low, Fred.
All right, let's make it 250.
Not good enough. You said there's already a crew of mercs there.
I did say that, didn't I? How about 300?
Anything more you can tell me about Hallucigen?
Like I said, that name's killer. They probably made all kinds of chemicals worth grabbing. The gunners were willing to send a team in there, and those guys don't go after lame marks.
All right, Fred. We have a deal.
You're the best. The absolute best.
Before you even start, let's get to the point. We have rooms. One room specifically. Payment due up front.
Can you tell me a bit about this hotel?
Oh, why do they always have questions? The Hotel Rexford used to be a grand establishment. We even had guests that didn't throw up all over the floor. But now the only people who come by are looking for somewhere to nurse a hangover or shoot up chems. So, still want a room?
Let me think it over.
It's the decor, isn't it? You again. Staying with us today, I trust.
Who owns this place?
Mr. Morawski. Oh, you should have seen him in his day. This place used to be flowing with high-end chems, beautiful clients, and oh, the parties. But now he just stews in the back office and disgraces his parents' memory. I swear, if they knew how far he's fallen, they'd die all over again. So why don't you rent a room before I get worked up?
Tell me more about this Morawski character.
Oh, why bother? He's worthless. The other big names caught him with his pants down, and now he just has this ratty hotel. That's the way Good Neighbor operates. The strong make it to the top until someone stronger kicks him down. Now, are you buying this room or not?
Tell me a bit about yourself, Claire.
I have been working in this hotel for over 40 years, and this is not how I imagined spending my retirement. Now, are you done being nosy, or are you getting a room?
Here's your money.
The room is on the top floor. When you come to the hallway, it's the last one on the right.
Boss Morawski don't like to be disturbed. Be quick.
Look, I know it's an open door, but it's like a philosophically open door, okay? Get the hell out.
What's up, Morawski?
You want a room? Claire runs the desk. Give her something to do besides breathing down my neck.
Excuse me.
Hotel ain't what it used to be, but don't go shooting it up.
Hi.
What? No. It can't. It's you. From Sanctuary Hills, right?
Wait. Are you from Vault-Tec?
I am Vault-Tec. 20 years of loyal service. And now look at me. I wasn't on the list. But you. Look at you. 200 years, and you're still perfect. How? How's that possible?
The vault had these pods that froze us in place. I only thawed out recently.
What? Vault-Tec never told me that. Unbelievable. Well, I had to get to the future the hard way. Living through the filth, the decay, and the bloodshed. Look at me. I'm a ghoul. A freak.
I'm so sorry. I didn't know this would happen.
You know, you're the only other person I met from before. Oh, God. I've been so alone here. No Commonwealth settlement. Once a ghoul with 200 years of Vault-Tec sales experience.
Hey, you know, you could head back to Sanctuary. I'll come visit. I promise.
Really? You will? Okay. I'll head over there right now. You promise you'll come visit, right? I'll see you there.
Hey.
You're going to come visit, right?
Your room is upstairs, top floor. The last one on the right down the long hall.
That's a great one, isn't it? Orange-colored sky by Nat King Cole. You're tuned to the Commonwealth's only respite from the tedium and desperation of post-apocalyptic life. Diamond City Radio. Up next is another favorite from Ella Fitzgerald, brought to you by the one, the only, Travis Lonely Miles.
I am so happy.
Yeah?
What, you need something to take the edge off? Fred Allen, Hotel Rexford.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Smell yes. That?
Hell of a load you're carrying. Better sell some to Daisy before someone swipes it.
Can't believe it. He looked just like Sammy, too.
Sure as hell didn't act like him. Institute thinks they can replace people with synths in this town? They got another thing coming.
What am I gonna tell his mother?
Hey, just a friendly neighborhood watch. Shooting down it.
You eyeballing me? Meat? Unless you want a hurting, move along.
Silver Shroud fans, a once-in-a-lifetime announcer. Silver Shroud returns, and he's gonna clean up the streets.
You messed with me.
Everyone heard how Wayne Delancey was selling his kid over a few lousy caps. Death is coming for you, Wayne.
Galaxy News Radio.
When evil walks the streets of Boston, one man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty. That guardian is the Silver Shroud. Today's episode, a slaying in Scully Square.
Just down this alley.
Well, well, well. Looks like someone got lost.
Friend of the show, Jerry, is here.
Is this thing on? Hello? Hello?
It's on. We're recording in here. Aw, man. Great. Great. The Silver Shroud's dispatched justice already. Miss Selmy has been avenged.
Shit, the Shroud off Wayne?
Got Wayne's a reason this guy's to be bothering me. I just had to shoot up a synth body snatcher over here.
So, Jerry, go on. Tell the listeners about what we're talking about.
Yeah, unbelievable, huh?
Right.
So Sammy was fine a few days ago, and then bam, he's acting funny. Gives up cigarettes, the booze, stops cheating on his wife. I mean, the man wasn't a saint, but he was who he was, you know. The Institute ain't got no right to replace him with a synth double. Look, we gotta clean up here. You keep close to you and yours, all right?
No, he's gonna do something about it. H.A.'s selling the kids.
Oh, jeez.
And his chems have killed people.
And? I don't get it.
We can't let A.J. kill kids.
Whatever.
We ain't the only friends of A.J.
Galaxy!
Keep your hands.
Hey, you.
Radio.
This is my turf. And I don't appreciate what you're calling me.
Walks the streets of Boston. One man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent.
Silver Shroud, fret not, old friend. It's only me.
Mistress of Mystery, what brings you to Scully Square on such a foul night?
The Silver Shroud's bringing justice to Good Neighbor. You bad guys better look out. And now, a special update. The villainous assassin Kendra was recently spotted at the third rail. The same Kendra who bombed Little Joe's shack and killed four innocent drifters. If you want to see the Silver Shroud in action, stay near Whitechapel Charlie. The Shroud's sure to interrogate him to find the evildoer's whereabouts.
Galaxy News Radio.
When evil walks the streets of Boston, one man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty. That guardian is the Silver Shades episode.
God says newcomers are welcome in the third rail. Go on in. Downstairs. Don't bother the other patrons.
chamomile. Pain. Ecstasy. This can only be the den of mysteries.
Be still, sweet Shroud. I removed that scumbag slug, but you're sick with fever and still suffering.
Mistress of Mysteries, no. I'm all right. But the mayor, Fat Fady, we stumbled upon a most sinister plot, old friend.
Ha! No, dear heart. The Shroud stumbled. The mistress.
Did you come in just for the
one thing for MacCready? He's in the back room.
A broken down dream.
God, I love this song.
Make way for paying customers. Want a pint, mate?
Your ear for Magnolia, better drink up. Got no tolerance for freeloaders here.
What's on tap?
Ain't no mandolin lager. But it's cold, it's wet, and guaranteed rad-free. It'll give you a jolt in all the right circuits. But if you're searching
for something... I'm looking for someone. Kendra.
Kendra is not one to be trifled with. People associated with her have a habit of being found face down in a ditch. If you're set on meeting her, for a fee it can be arranged.
Can you spare a few details on her, at least? On the house?
You got to have finesse to be an assassin. Kendra's a murderer. A very skilled murderer. Listen, mate, the combat scan shows you know what you're all about. Save your camps, buy a lager instead.
I'm not hiring her. I'm going to kill her.
You serious? Sarcasm. Sometimes bungs up me processes. In that case, she's got a flat just south of Goodneighbor. Water Street Apartments. Yep, for the blighters she's got with her. Nasty piece of business, then. Good luck.
Charlie.
Boy, we got beer. You ain't buying beer, you ain't buying.
Who's the singer?
That is Magnolia. Flower of the Third Rail. Anything you want to know about her other than that is her business. Now, you're gonna order?
The Third Rail. Is this your place?
What? Nah, Cove. Place is Hancock's. Old Charlie just keeps the floor clean and drinks dirty. So, you buying or what?
So Hancock's the owner?
That's right. Owner and mayor of this whole bloody town. Trust me, never get on his bad side. stay clear of his bodyguard. So, what's your poison?
Hancock has a bodyguard?
Yeah. A redhead with the condescending stare. Trust me, Cuff, something about her ain't right. Not that I'd ever admit saying that. I'm trying to sell drinks here. You in?
What's the word around town?
Well, they say there's a newcomer around here who doesn't understand that I'm a bartender, not a damn newsbot. Now, are you gonna drink?
I'll take a look, sure.
Here's to drowning sorrows. Now that you're licked up, got a proposition for you. I need a dirty boy to do some dirty, dirty work. Blood on the pavement, bodies in the ground, that kind of thing. Interested?
I want to hear the details first.
I got a certain anonymous client who's paying top dollar for a clean-up job. 3 locations. Everyone inside. No witnesses. Only catch? It's all in town. The old warehouses, so I can't use my regulars. Too noticeable. That's where you come in. The job's 200 caps. Payment after it's done. And don't worry, I'll know when it is.
I don't do work unless I know who's paying the bills.
All right, Gov. Not like it's a big secret who I represent. Mayor Hancock is fronting the caps. Internal political struggle. You know how it is. Look, it's nothing you need to be concerned about. Just clear out the warehouses and get paid. Simple.
3 locations? That's a lot of time. A lot of bullets.
Well, I guess we could sweeten the pot a bit. 250.
Too low. Barely covers the risks.
All right, Dove. 300.
I'll get it done.
You better. Now go out there and bust some heads.
Excuse me, miss?
Hmm? What's the matter, handsome? Don't tell me you didn't like the song.
I love the song. It was perfect.
Oh, well, thank you. A girl tries her best. Now, there's something special about you, isn't there? Don't tell me. Let me guess. I think I know a fellow performer when I see one. You're good with your words. Know just the right thing to say at the right time. So what brings a man like you to my part of town?
I came here for the music.
Flatterer. I think you and I are gonna get along. So it's my turn to answer questions, right? What can I do for you?
I was wondering if we could get to know each other better.
Oh, really? Go on.
You, me, an evening walk under the streetlights.
And then what?
Music.
I knew you were something special, all right. Let me get my coat.
What's your story? How'd you end up singing here?
Oh, I flew into town like any songbird does, on a heavy wind with a wounded wing. Well, this place has a stage. I needed to sing. And Whitechapel Charlie needed customers, so here we are. Was there anything else?
Whitechapel Charlie's been here a long time, I take it?
Well, he never talks too much about his past. Neither do I, really. I guess that's why we get along. You should get to know him, though. Order a drink first. He always wants to talk business after someone's had a few. And was that all? You need anything else?
Come on. Tell me the whole story. Who were you before all this?
You really want to know? It's all in the songs. Everything I am. Now, can I help you with anything else?
I wouldn't mind hearing a different song.
The audience is always right.
Yeah.
Need a place to stay? Try Hotel Rexford.
Running from something? Welcome home.
Can't say I'm surprised to find you in a dump like this, MacReady.
I was wondering how long it would take your bloodhounds to track me down, Winlock. It's been almost 3 months. Don't tell me you're getting rusty. Should we take this outside?
It ain't like that. I'm just here to deliver a message.
In case you forgot, I left the Gunners for good.
Yeah, I heard. But you're still taking jobs in the Commonwealth. That isn't going to work for us.
I don't take orders from you. Not anymore. So why don't you take your girlfriend and walk out of here while you still can?
What? Winlock, tell me we don't have to listen to this shit.
Listen up, MacReady. The only reason we haven't filled your body full of bullets is that we don't want a war with Good Neighbor. See, we respect other people's boundaries. We know how to play the game. It's something you never learned.
Glad to have disappointed you.
You can play the tough guy all you want. But if we hear you're still operating inside Gunner territory, all bets are off. You got that?
You finished?
Yeah. We're finished. Come on, Barnes.
Hi.
Get out of my face.
Hey there.
Here on Gunner business, so back off.
Look, pal. If you're preaching about the Atom or looking for a friend, you've got the wrong guy. If you need a hired gun, then maybe we can talk.
Maybe. Why don't you tell me who those guys were first?
A couple of morons looking to climb the ladder of success by stepping on everyone else on the way up. Shouldn't be surprised, though. That's how it goes when you run with the Gunners.
Never heard of the Gunners. Who are they?
One of the biggest gangs in the Commonwealth. Got a rep for being crazy. You know, so tightly wound, you'd think they were a cult or something. Stuck with them for a while because the money was good, but it never fit in. That's why I made a clean break and started flying solo. Now what about you? How do I know I won't end up with a bullet in my back?
Are you always this suspicious?
Hey, you approached me. And frankly, I'm taking a huge risk being out here in the Commonwealth in the first place. So I'm not about to leave anything to chance. Which brings me back to my original question. Can I trust you?
Hold on. What kind of risk are you talking about?
I already told you way too much. I need to learn to keep my big mouth shut. Look, I'm tired of playing 20 questions. So I'll cut you a deal right now. 250 caps. Up front. And there's no room for bargaining. What do you say?
Everything's negotiable. Would you take 200?
Drive a hard bargain. But you just bought yourself an extra gun. All right, boss. Let's get out of here.
Codsworth.
May I accompany you, sir?
Would you like to?
Why, yes, of course, sir.
Mm-hmm. Not now, Codsworth.
I see, sir.
Hey.
Need something?
Excuse me.
What's on your mind?
Your thoughts?
Let's get this show on the road.
Your thoughts?
The open road and a loaded weapon. Doesn't get much better than this.
How do you feel about us?
I don't know. I haven't killed you yet. Isn't that good enough?
Didn't have anything else.
Fine by me.
Hey!
What do you want?
Yes.
Yeah?
Magnolia.
Something I can do for you, handsome?
Yeah. Let's get out of here.
Let me get my coat. I haven't been out on the town in too long. Thank you. I'm afraid my first love is always going to be the stage, though. I hope you understand. I just can't get too attached. I'll see you around, Good Neighbor. When I'm up there singing, I'll be thinking of you.
Hey, Magnolia.
I have to head back.
walks the streets of Boston. One man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty. That guardian is the Silver Shroud. Today's episode, Fat Fahey's Folly.
Come on, Dollface. It's right through here.
Another special update. No, it wasn't Bobby No-Nose who offed AJ
this
and his
place
goons.
Ain't what it used to be.
It was the Silver Shroud. See his calling card if you don't believe me. Now's our time, listeners. Justice is coming, a good neighbor. You'll see.
Radio!
That's freedom.
You're blocking my life.
When evil walks the streets of Boston, one man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging
your
the guilty. That guardian is the Silver Shroud. Today's episode, Into the Robot's Den.
That's all of them. Fat Fahey's mob bots have been sent back to the mechanical hell that spawned them.
Yes, my choleric companion. And no, robotic hellspawn they were. But not Fat Fahey. For he himself presented the facts. Someone else is actually...
the master of it all. You're right. But who? Dearest mistress of mysteries, you and I have battled Boston's rogues gallery for years. This... see someone new.
Certainly. But which criminal culprit has the technological know-how to construct such clockwork calamities? I don't...
You don't know anything? Yeah, right. But I do see. And I'll tell you too. On one condition. By the shadowed streaks of Southie, one of the mob bots' heads... he's still talking.
Detected. Curious. I am detected.
You know how right I am. I can't feel my legs, because you shot me up, God Shroud. But I still got my kisser, see? And I'm gonna use it to tell you where the big boss man is, see? And your one condition. You take my head with you, so I can see you take that creep down. What did he ever do for me, huh? spoil all the fun. You gotta see for yourself. Come on, let's be feet. To the big warehouse down at Pier 12.
Fucking hide from me.
Fine.
You're dead.
A more automaton. Or wait. Gathering below is unlike any soiree I've ever seen.
Robots. Dozens of them. All shapes and sizes. And on the stage, their leader. Another robot. No! Not a robot! A man in a robot costume! Shh! Shut up, you dummies! Us robots got good hearing! You better get yourselves caught! Now listen. Boss man's about that talk. My robotic children, my glorious creations, we stand tonight at the dawn of a new era. For too long, the human vermin of Boston have destroyed this fair city. The flesh is weak, but steel is strong. You, my children, will usher in a new age, an age of robots, led by me, your father, the Mechanist!
That's it.
The Mechanist. So, evil does have a name. The revolution begins tonight, my precious offspring. But first, let us welcome our special guests for this evening. Silver Shroud and the Mistress of Mystery.
Our stalwart hero! Find out what happens next week on another exciting episode of The Silver Shroud!
Safety off. I think we have company.
You've been listening to Galaxy News Radio, a wholly owned subsidiary of Galaxy News Network.
Galaxy News Radio!
When evil walks the streets of Boston, one man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty. That guardian is the Silver Shroud. Today's episode, The Mechanist Unmasked.
Shroud. But that malformed murderer was but a muppet compared to the malignancy of the Mechanist.
Malignant, am I? No, Mistress of Mystery. What you mistake for evil is actually enlightenment. Only I, the Mechanist, truly understand the folly of humankind. The flesh is weak. Metal is the future of Massachusetts.
The only future you have is a long nap in a deep hole, Mechanist. To me, you're just another two-bit hustler with delusions of grandeur. And by the way, you're not fooling anyone with that cheap getup. You're as human as the rest of us.
Stalwart Shroud, glance skyward and see. Our newfound friend, the head of the bodiless butt. And it would seem he's biting through our bindings.
Hey, down there! Mechanist! You robot wannabe! Remember me? No? I didn't think so. That's the problem. You made me, but you didn't love me! You didn't love any of us, you selfish jamalk! Now, it's time to pay!
Gasp!
Fools, all of you! Attack my robot children! Destroy these interlopers!
The robots are advancing, and our weapons have been confiscated. So, fisticuffs it is, then.
And furiously fluid footwork! Hi-ya!
By order of our master, the Mechanist, You will be destroyed. Destroy it.
And that, is the last of them. Now, for the Mechanist. But where did that vile ruffian escape to?
Hey, Silver Dukora, it's me, the head. Yeah, that's right. I'm up here in the rafters. I'm your eye in the sky. I saw where the Mechanist went. He's in that office, up the stairs.
Well done, heroic head. Your adjusted attitude has made allies of us all. Silver Shroud, shall we?
We shall.
Stop right there! Not a step closer! You may have defeated my robot children, but now I will turn your own weapon against you!
Silver Shroud! He's armed with your silver shooter! Your most revered rifle!
So he is, Mistress. So he is. All right, Mechanist. It's your move. Shoot! If you've got the chutzpah.
I have been waiting for this moment a long time, Silver Shroud. With you and your harlot out of the way, the age of the robots can truly begin. Now, die.
Silver Shroud, the bullets, they bounced, ricocheted right off your raiment, right back at...
And says welcome like the
another headliner. Hancock
garbage.
Seeks a special meeting with our hero, the Silver Shroud. Whatever it's about, be careful, Shroud. We're all with you.
Galaxy News Radio.
When evil walks the streets of Boston, one man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty. That guardian is the Silver Shroud. Today's episode, a slaying in Scully Square.
Down this alley.
Well, well, well. Looks like someone got lost on the wrong side of the tracks. Yeah, wrong side of the tracks.
I'm just meeting a friend. No business of yours. Perhaps I'll just call him. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Not so fast, fancy pants. Your wallet. And that snazzy... Oh, no.
Mayor Hancock?
That's what someone tells
hand him
me.
Over.
Some
now.
Costume freak
I
is
most certainly will not.
Neighbor.
Do you have
and the
any
kicker
idea
is,
who...
me. How should I feel about this?
Oh, jeez Louise. Why'd you go and do that?
This neighborhood is ill.
Why. You want to
spend
another stretch
am
of
the cure.
You're now, priceless. Like the Silver Shroud himself walked out of a comic book into my den. Just priceless. You've been busy scaring people, bashing
nothing.
In a few faces.
No cash.
I respect that. So far. But I gotta ask one freak to another.
Like
why the getup?
All right. Let's
many have sought to pierce the shroud. To no avail.
You just don't stop. Stay you,
time.
Pal.
You know
the
police
you took
we
out all belong to the same asshole.
What?
And that asshole's planning some old-fashioned revenge on you. You dig? Fortunate for you, I want Sinjin to take a dirt nap.
Sure.
He's taken 2-bit raider outfits and made them scary. Small fish now, but if left alone.
Blood. Justice must
he
be
will be judged for his crimes.
Trust me, he needs a lot of judging. Got a lead on 2 of his own. Smiling Kate and Northy. Smiley is gathering
come
a posse
out and
to
I'll
take
do you like
you
I did
out.
The mayor.
And Northy is just running scared. Hired himself
you,
some goons,
and
pulling up a prospect. Just keep piling those body bags up. until we find the location of the big guy himself.
No! My work.
Getting rid of
Sin Jin
helps you too. Some appreciation is in order.
What brought you to Scully Square?
Sin Jin's got a powerful hater brewing. If you deal with Sin Jin, then I'm inclined to show you some gratitude. You feel me?
We didn't get to the top of this town.
Emerge from the shadows, villain, or face the justice.
Hey, I don't mean to pitch. Aren't you supposed to be heading the Pikmin Gallery for me?
What will become of us?
Looking for more work if you got any.
Nothing right now, sorry. Check around the net.
Another exciting episode of
The Silver Shroud!
You've been listening to Galaxy News Radio, a wholly owned subsidiary of Galaxy News Network.
Galaxy News Radio!
When evil walks the streets of Boston, one man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty. That guardian is the Silver Shroud! Today's episode, The Mystery of Mayor Murphy.
Silver Shroud. Fret not, old friend. It's only me.
Mistress of Mystery, what brings you to Scully Square on such a foul night?
Tracking our dear Mayor Murphy.
My business partner
hates
it.
Up to some mischief.
So she's not the fun.
The mayor.
Hey, Irma.
So he wasn't
here in
some kind of
official capacity. Memory loungers come from, you ask?
Well, hardly. Here, let me show you. The contents of the late mayor's case.
But these are real estate papers. Leases and deeds for most of the businesses in Scully Square.
Indeed they are, my intrepid investigator. It would seem our Mayor Murphy was involved in a rather crooked caper. He was here to meet with some other mysterious malefactor.
So, Mr. Mayor, I hope you found the place all... What the? Silver Shroud? And Mistress of Mystery? And the Mayor? Dead?
That Fahey! The infamous mob boss! So, you were meeting with Mayor Murphy. But why? Tell me, and you may yet live.
Best listen to my friend, Fahey.
I'll never talk, and you two are in over your heads.
So be it. Death has come for you, evildoer, and I am its...
Shroud? Shroud this, crime fighter? Later, suckers!
Silver Shroud, you're shot!
Just a graze. You must go after him.
No, we'll let our quarry flee for now. That bullet must be removed, and you're bleeding badly.
Must get back to my...
Hush now, Stoic Shroud. I'll take you to my parlor. It is close, and that wound is worrisome.
The parlor? It's been so long.
Indeed it has, old friend. Old love. Indeed it has. And now, we must away!
What will become of our stalwart hero? Find out what happens next week on another exciting episode of... The Silver Shroud!
You've been listening to Galaxy News Radio, a wholly owned subsidiary of Galaxy News Network.
Galaxy News Radio!
When evil walks the streets of Boston, one man lurks in the shadows, shielding the innocent, judging the guilty. that guardian is the Silver Shroud. Today's episode in the Parlor of Mysteries.
Jasmine, chamomile, pain, ecstasy. This can only be the Den of Mysteries.
Be still, sweet Shroud. I removed that scumbag slug, but you're sick with fever and still suffering.
Mistress of Mysteries, no. I'm all right. But the mayor, Fat Fatey, we stumbled upon a most sinister plot, old friend.
Ha! No, dear heart. The Shroud stumbled. The mistress maneuvered. I knew of the mayor's misdeeds for many days. I followed him to that fateful meeting with Fat Fahey. I was about to...
Attention! Silver Shroud and Mistress of Mystery! This is Chief Corcoran of the Boston Police Department. We know you're in there. You are both wanted in connection with the murder of Mayor Murphy. Come out with your hands up!
It would seem that our leaving the scene of the Scale slaughter was terribly timed. Incurring the wrath of Boston's finest is an unfortunate and unexpected annoyance.
Unexpected by us?
Don't bother asking me how the memory lines work.
Perhaps not by...
I don't have time to teach the years of neurophysiology.
I'm starting to see into his twisted plan. Ah! Damn this gunshot wound!
Look, heroes! We can clear this up. Come out now unarmed. I'll see that you two get the best lawyers in the city.
Excuse my assumption that even the most astute attorney couldn't help us now.
You're right, mistress. We must away from your den and evade the police. Clear our names and take Fahey down.
That's it! We're coming in!
Silver Shroud, Mistress of Mystery, hands up per order of the Boston Police.
Chief Corcoran, I am Death's Shroud, but you are undeserved of my terrible justice. Think on my mercy.
Stop or we'll shoot! Men! Open fire! Damn it!
Wait, it's clearing. Chief, they ain't here. They're gone.
I was hoping you'd say that, Officer Leibowitz.
That was Billie Holiday. Diamond City Radio wouldn't be possible without the help of some wonderful businesses here in town. Commonwealth Weaponry. It's a dangerous world out there. Protect yourself. Protect your family. Ladies, I bet every one of you out there knows the man like the one Betty Hutton sang about. Shears and heat. The devil.
No.
Some very bad people may be coming. It's not safe here.
Hey there.
Please, don't come any closer.
Has to be something worth a few caps in here.
Yo, psst. Hold.
Yeah, what is it?
Thank you.
What's up?
Let's go.
Easy.
Hope you enjoyed that last number. Non-stop music and all the latest news. This is Diamond City Radio. Here's a throwback to simpler times, when folks actually went looking for radioactive material. It's Elton Britt with Uranium Fever.
Got it. came to visit. I almost thought you wouldn't.
This place is starting to look like a proper home, thanks to you.
I'm feeling swell. Look at the two of us here in Sanctuary. Prepare for the future.
Time to kick some ass.
Take care of yourself, dear.
This place is really coming together, huh? I can't take all the credit.
Hello, sir.
That, bless her heart, was Skeeter Davis. Now, folks, I'm sure you've all seen or heard about the latest issue of Public Occurrences. Some bold claims by our intrepid reporter. Since possibly living among us, undetected. Very serious implications. Wouldn't you agree? The mayor's office has, of course, issued a statement.
They didn't tell me much. Vault Tech. Just to make sure everyone filled out their forms.
The mayor himself.
I was supposed to win a pack of steak knives.
Unfounded. Good to know, I guess. But between you and me, listeners, I'm gonna keep my eye open just to be on the safe side. Well, never a dull moment here at Diamond City Radio. Next is Personality by Johnny Mercer. Really great horn licks on this one. And no, that's not me being suggestive.
Thank you. It's like I can finally think straight.
Hey, Sheffield. What do you think about coming to work for me?
I gave up alcohol after settling down here. Doctor said I shot my liver.
Heads up.
Well?
Hey. Nona Harris folks. Let's hope his grandma got the help she needed.
What do we have here?
Good news is something often in short supply in the coming. So I'm happy to be able to deliver a little bit to you. If you were one of the folks worrying in hushed tones about the whereabouts of Diamond City's most effective detective, you can rest easy. Nick Valentine is back in town and seemingly none the worse for wear. While details about what happened to him are scarce, I for one am just glad he's back. And in one piece. And if there's any more good news to share, you'll hear it first here on Diamond City Radio. Sentimental or sappy, here's one more tomorrow, folks. You make the call. Nona Harris, folks. Let's hope his grandma got the help she needed. Good news is something often in short supply in the Commonwealth, folks. So I'm happy to be
to you. If you were one of the folks worrying in hushed tones about the whereabouts of Diamond City's most effective detective, you can rest easy. Nick Valentine is back in town and... While the tales about what happened to him are scarce, I, for one, am just glad he's back. And in one piece. And if there's any more good news to share, you'll hear it first here on Diamond City Radio. The next one is Keep a Knockin' by Louis Jordan.
plywood. How's that supposed to get me ready for this?
That old stuff worth anything?
Call a confirmed kill.
Hey, folks. We've got word coming in. Settlement found to the northwest. Some brave, enterprising folks have decided to settle Sanctuary. We wish that the best. It never hurts to have one more safe, reliable place in the Commonwealth.
I'll make this quick.
Related news. It sounds like the Minutemen may be getting back on their feet. And that's definitely good. Anyone willing to take a stand for safety in the Commonwealth is okay in my book. For anyone coming back to Diamond City from a trip out in the Commonwealth, this one's for you.
How are they?
Drop dead on.
Okay, that looked like it hurt.
Got it.
Getting tired yet? Should've just run! Just had to play hero, huh? Disappearing act, huh? No sign of him now.
It.
Nothing there now. What the hell was that? Must be going crazy. You're mine now!
Just heard Undecided by Ella Fitzgerald. The smooth sounds of Diamond City Radio are brought to you by the following. Commonwealth Weaponry. It's a dangerous world out there. Protect yourself. Protect your family. Here's a throwback to simpler times when folks actually went looking for radioactive material. It's Elton Britt with Uranium Fever.
startup sequence unknown. Hardware detected. Auxiliary BIOS detected. Flashing operational subroutines. Micro brewers operational. Internal bottling mechanism operational. Output dispensary operational. Detecting brewing subroutines. Holotape detected for Women Pale Ale. Startup sequence complete. Dispensing sample for approval by technician. How would you describe the testing sample provided?
Cold and refreshing. Do you know how long it's been since I had cold beer?
Very good. I appear to be operating at an optimal level. Shall we commence delivery to the Hotel Rexford?
Yeah, sure.
Beginning transit operations to Hotel Rexford.
Hey, buddy.
Currently en route to home. Location. Care to wet your whistle? Or do you require a lap?
Tell me a joke.
C, E flat, and G walk into a bar. The bartender says, "Sorry, but we don't serve minors in here." Ha, ha, ha. So E-flat leaves, while C and G have a fifth between them. Would you like a cold one, or did you want to hear a joke?
Can I still change the home parameter?
Current home parameter is set to Hotel Rexford. Shall we commence delivery to the Hotel Rexford?
What are you?
I am a modified Robco Protectron designated drinking buddy. My internal microbrewers allows for the internal brewing, bottling, and dispensing of beer at an accelerated rate. I am also programmed to tell a wide variety of jokes for the customer's amusement. Shall we commence delivery to the Hotel Rexford?
Yeah, sure.
Beginning transit operation.
personality by Johnny Mercer. If you're from out of town, be sure to visit Diamond City. It's safe, it's secure, and full of quality establishments like this. Commonwealth Weaponry. It's a dangerous world out there. Protect yourself. Protect your family. Here's one from Cole Porter that I don't think Diamond City Security would totally agree with. It's anything goes.
Normal. Law and order has been restored.
Well, we're not going to need that stuff anymore.
Thank you.
out.
I hope you're buying. Even a girl with an arse.
Sure. Let's take a look.
A gun for every.
Mm-hmm.
Outside Diamond City. Details are scarce, but it sounds like whatever happened, it was pretty violent. While there's no official connection, it has been noted that Diamond City resident Henry Cook went missing at approximately the same time. If we're able to verify any further details of this story, we'll pass them on to you, listeners. Just another day in the Commonwealth, huh, folks? Travis Lonely Miles here, bringing you Louis Jordan with Keep a Knockin', which is what you just got to do until the damn door opens.
Don't ask questions in good neighborhood. Better for everyone.
The memory den's great. Just don't get hooked like old Kent. Poor bastard's got to be stuck in the past.
Hey, where you got left up? You okay?
Bunch of raiders came. Muscle.
No shit. You should have hollered. I would have had your back.
Nah, I took care of it. Don't mind a hand later, though. Gotta toss a couple of sandwiches over the barricade.
Greetings, new friends. I am the
Rufus.
Rufus,
what
buddy.
The heck is this thing?
You can
it's
just
that brewing
machine
I was telling
buddy.
You about.
I am here to provide entertainment and
oh, man.
My skull
that's
libations.
Awesome. I'm going to store my
fine.
Vodka
just
in this
get
thing.
It set up over at the bar and out of my doorway.
Commencing normal operations. Greetings, buddy. Here for a laugh? Or did you want a cup?
Hey, Rufus.
Hey, thanks for your help. Buddy here is even better than I was hoping for. Here's your money. Hey.
Not right now. Sure. See you around.